Space, the final frontier. And for anyone unfortunate enough to be sucked out an airlock without a spacesuit, it will definitely be the fatal frontier. It's an old Hollywood trope. Humans inside a flimsy spacecraft have an accident of some type, and now the hull's been breached and everyone is about 2 seconds away from becoming human popsicles, or having their eyeballs explode. But is that really what happens to you if you stepped out of a spacecraft unprotected? Hello and welcome to another episode of the Infographic Show. Today we're taking a look at what would happen to your body in space. The most obvious problem you're going to have if you're sucked out into space is a lack of oxygen. Space is a nearly perfect vacuum, meaning there's not much gas to breathe in, let alone breathable O2. So if you find yourself aboard some space disaster, then you clearly should hold your breath and try to claw your way to safety, right? Wrong. That would actually be almost instantly fatal for you. As we mentioned, space is an almost perfect vacuum, and if you tried to hold your breath, you would be pitting your own chest muscles against the strength of space itself, and that's a fight you're gonna lose. The oxygen in your lungs will immediately expand and rupture your lungs, being released into the circulatory system and ripped out of your chest, along with large parts of your now shredded lung tissues. So instead of holding your breath, you want to breathe out as completely as possible and make sure your lungs are empty. Don't worry, your brain will continue to remain conscious for about 15 seconds, and you can survive up to 2 minutes with little risk of permanent damage. With no atmospheric pressure squeezing down on your body, the next thing to happen will be the vaporization of water in your body. In a normal situation, water molecules are constantly being blown off, but by being repelled with their air molecules, the water remains in equilibrium with the air. Without any atmosphere, though, water will begin to evaporate throughout your entire body, causing you to start swelling like a naughty kid inside Willy Wonka's chocolate factory. You'll eventually swell to about twice normal size, but because human skin is incredibly elastic and durable, you won't burst like a giant meat balloon. If you get rescued at this point, you'll actually return to normal and you should be fine, though we wouldn't recommend it. If rescue isn't forthcoming though, then you're gonna be in incredible amounts of pain. And if you were hoping to instantly black out due to a lack of blood pressure, then we got some bad news for you. Your circulatory system is so robust that it's able to keep your blood pressurized even in the vacuum of space. So as you swell up like a party balloon, you can look forward to retaining full consciousness as the blood keeps on pumping, at least until the oxygen stored in your blood runs out after 15 seconds. Moisture on the exterior of your body, though, and in places like your eyes and tongue, will immediately begin to boil due to the lack of atmospheric pressure. Yet this isn't a hot type of boiling, but rather a very violent form of evaporation. So you won't cook yourself alive either. If you are ejected into space in direct line of sight of a star, then you can expect to receive an incredibly bad sunburn on whatever side of your body is facing that star, thanks to unfiltered solar radiation. Depending on how far you are from the star, though, you might not receive enough heat to be seriously burned. But if you went for a stroll outside the International Space Station's airlock with no spacesuit, you could expect a severe and very immediate sunburn. You'll likely also be bombarded by huge amounts of cosmic radiation, especially if you're outside the protective magnetosphere of a large planet. Our suggestion is to spin rapidly. That way you'll be crispy nice and evenly. We all know space is cold, roughly 2.7 Kelvin, or negative 270 degrees Celsius, or negative 455 degrees Fahrenheit. You'd probably expect that your corpse would then rapidly freeze without any protection, but actually, you could stay relatively warm for a pretty long amount of time. That's because your body and skin is a pretty excellent insulator. And because space is a vacuum, there's nothing to lose heat to via convection or conduction. Here on Earth, we're constantly surrounded by atmospheric gases, so when it gets cold, they're able to leach heat from our body and carry it away, making us cold. In space, though, there's no medium to lose heat to, so your core body temperature would remain warm for a decent amount of time. Once you're dead, though, well, you're not gonna change much for a long, long, long time. On Earth, we decompose as we're eaten up by the bacteria inside of us, billions of tiny, hungry little life forms just waiting to eat you alive that keeps your body in constant check throughout your immune system. But once that immune system fails, those bacteria finally have their chance to turn you into a buffet, and they gorge themselves while rapidly procreating. Think about that next time you buy some probiotic yogurt. You're just making those little bacteria stronger, and they're patiently waiting for your immune system to slip up so they can eat you from the inside out. In space, though, the extreme radiation and temperatures will kill that bacteria before it can consume much of your body, leaving your corpse perfectly preserved for millions and millions of years. If you're close to a star, you'll mummify, much like an ancient Egyptian, Only when aliens find you millions of years later, you'll actually be in a lot better shape than them. So if you know anyone really vain in your life, you should recommend they die in space. What other strange places and what they would do to your body would you like to know about? Should we really be eating probiotic foods when it's just making the bacteria that will consume us all in the end stronger? Let us know in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other video called What Happens When You Die. Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.